Tonight. And if you would please say hello to Mark Maestro right here with me helping out with the music. Give Mark some love, will you? We've got some great music and some great people behind the curtain. We want all your enthusiasm to welcome them into the room. So Mark, without further ado. There we go from Michael Bublé, everything, everybody. How about a great big hand for parents of the bride, Jeff and Julie Hilt. A great big hand for parents of the groom, Alan and Ruth Sokolik. A great big hand for Jessica Kelly, escorted by Mr. Tyler York. Come on, give us some more. We're up here doing it now. Let's go. Welcome Lindsay Berry, escorted by Mr. Costa Nikolazakis. Next we have Sister of the Groom, Maggie Sokolik, with Jocelyn Smallwood and Jacob Kayapa.
Once again, everybody, that is Maggie Sokolik, escorted by Jocelyn Smallwood and Jacob Panta. Maid of Honor, Melanie Alberta, escorted by the best man, Mr. Jordan Wilson. This time, everybody, if we could please rise to the occasion, put your hands together and help me welcome the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Jenna and David Sokolik. Come on, let's hear it, folks. One more time, everybody, let's go.
Big hand, Mr. Jeff Wilt.
All right. Good evening, everyone. I'm the father of the bride, I think. Normally known as Jeff, sometimes dad, sometimes grandpa, sometimes buddy. Hey, buddy, what are you doing over there? I have a quick story to tell you. I want to thank everybody for coming tonight, especially the people that have come long distances. I know some people have come from California. Our son and family came from Houston. Lobby came from Dublin, Ohio, and fought the roundabouts in Dublin, so. Sometimes I get in a spin in the roundabouts and I don't know how to get out. I also want to thank the best damn man in the land. I've had this vision for a long time since Jenna and David came to us as ones that were dating about 5 years ago. And the vision is Midnight Ramp. Jenna had nothing on but her socks and shoes. She came down the ramp, out on the field, broke mid-arm swing, and looked over at David and said, "Nice." David comes down the ramp, same attire, but he's got orange socks on. He wants to be looked at. He wants to be sought out. David breaks arm swing and looks over at Jenna and says, "Sweet." So we can all say we're here tonight because of nice and sweet. Right? Going back to 1988, I came home late one night from a business trip, and Julie was sitting on the sofa with her legs banging together, saying things that, you know, "Why are you up so late?" Star Spangled Banner was playing, you know, back in 1988, there was no TV at night, right? So I asked her, I said, "What's wrong, are you sick?" She says, eventually, she blurts out, "I'm pregnant." So I said, "Okay, pregnant." 3 or 4 months later, her doctor, Ballinger, who's since retired from Dr. Allen's group practice, asked her to come in because they suspected another set of twins. I said, "Twins." So we went in, and guess who did the ultrasound? It was David's dad, Dr. Alan Sokol. So he's known Jenna way before she knew David. Pretty neat stuff, huh? Months later, Julie and I were huffing and puffing with Lamaze at Mount Carmel, right down the street here. And Dr. Beatty, which I believe is over at table 10, raise your hand, doctor, was there. And he finally said behind his mask, "It's a girl." I said, "Well, okay." I kind of thought it was a girl from the photographs that Alan had taken 6 months prior. So a lady over on the side of the room was using a towel to rub off Jenna's hair or head, and I had seen red up there before. I thought it was just blood from the birth, but she says, "Oh my goodness, such beautiful red hair." So about 4 years or 3 years later, some lady bent down to Jenna and said, "Where did you get that red hair?" Well, I had made up a joke beforehand that was the UPS man driving a small brown truck around our neighborhood and made a special delivery about 9 or 10 months prior to her birth. So she leans up to the lady and says, "UPS man." I was kind of embarrassed, but you know, Julie was a little bit too. David, I really want to welcome you to our family. When I mean that to you, I mean your family, your circle of friends. Obviously, you have a lot of friends that I haven't met, but I have met a lot of people from the OSU marching band through you. And your mom and dad and sister, it's been great. It has been great. I want to give you just a quick list of advice. Be positive in your marriage. Always communicate. If you have a problem, work it out among yourselves. And then if you don't have a solution, turn to your friends and family that are here today. This is a testament of your friends and family. So again, be positive and communicate. Your sister, Jessica, is looking down on us today. I know that for a fact. Her soul and her spirit is still with us. And I really think that is a positive thing because she did so much in her 38 years, more than I've ever thought about doing in my 63 years. So keep her in your heart, if you will. I'd like to introduce, again, the future doctor, David and Mrs. Jenna Sokol. Thank you. Who's going next?
Mr. Will, that's kind of hard to follow. You did a good job. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Melanie Alberta, and I've been lucky to know Jenna for the last 12 years. So, with great shock to you all, I'm sure our friendship began in high school marching band. It quickly grew, though, through a love of Gene Kelly, yoga, and my love, her complete distaste for math. So, we've shared in years of silliness and shenanigans and have probably eaten our body weight in Ben and Jerry's ice cream while binge-watching Avonlea. So we've been through a lot together, through so many good times, as well as some of the hardest times in our lives. And through it all, I can say Jenna is one of the most caring, loyal, and one of the strongest people I know. And with all of the time I've spent with you, I've never seen you happier than when you're with David. Okay. When my husband Brian and I got married, we found this Dr. Seuss saying that we really liked, and I think it's kind of fitting for today. And it goes, "We're all a little weird, and life's a little weird. And when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible to ours, we join up with them and fall in mutual weirdness and call it love." So I know it's a weird way of putting it, but you two are meant for each other. Your creativity, your senses of humor, your love of pugs, and even your fashion senses are a perfect match. You guys bring out the best weirdness in each other. David, I want to thank you for all of the love you've shown Jenna and for keeping her smiling through everything. I am truly so happy and excited for you guys and for all of the memories you're going to make together on your journey. So, here's to Jenna and David and their compatible weirdness and to a life of never-ending love and happiness.
Hi everybody, my name is Jordan and I've got a few words for everybody. I mostly want to use this speech to give some thanks out to people that are certainly deserving of it tonight. First I want to thank the parents of the bride and groom, Alan and Ruth Sokolik and Julie and Jeff Wilt. Can we please get a round of applause for the parents? You have raised the two fine people that are sitting up at this table tonight, and without you, they certainly wouldn't be here tonight. Next, I want to move on and thank the friends and family, the guests of the wedding that are here tonight. Your relationships have certainly helped mold them into the people that they are today. And most of all, I want to thank you guys for being here, because without you, there wouldn't be anybody to give me pity laughs for the bad jokes tonight. There they are, that's the pity laughs. Next I want to move on to thanking the groom, David, for always being there for me and for being one of my best friends over the years. I couldn't be happier to be standing up here tonight, giving the speech and probably making him worry that I'm gonna say something stupid during this. More pity laughs. David and I have known each other for about 6.5 years now, just a little over, which, side note, incidentally, is about as long as David's been fielding questions for when he proposed to Jenna. It's true. But David and I met back at the summer practices before our first year marching band together at Ohio State, and we were at the practices. We didn't say a word to each other, nothing. We didn't talk until we were actually in band, and during these practices leading up to tryouts, I kind of saw David as kind of this like unspoken rival that I had because he was a very talented marcher. He kind of looks like me a little bit, the same dark brown hair and the height, weight, both pre-medical students. So I thought, oh, this guy thinks he's better than me. He's a better version of me. So we got to tryouts, and there's some one-on-one marching between candidates at the tryouts, and on the last day, David and I got to go against each other, and I can tell you, I've never been more excited to compete against somebody, and we won't really go into who won that competition. But we got into band, and it's amazing to be standing up here today, because I the first conversation I remember having with David was our car ride that he drove me over to our first dinner as a group and band, and awkward as can be. I don't think we had a very good conversation, one, in that car ride, and it's amazing to be standing up here today giving a speech to one of my best friends. I'm so happy for you, so proud of you that you found the perfect woman for you and Jenna. So lastly, I wanna move on and thank the both of you for setting up this outstanding day for us to come and witness your lifetime commitment to each other. You've set up an absolutely beautiful ceremony. This reception is wonderful. Jenna, you look absolutely stunning. David, you look okay. But most of all, I want to thank you guys for being you, for being such fun and outgoing people to be around. And it's been such a joy to watch this relationship flourish over the years. Starting from the days before you started dating, when David would pick on Jenna at band seemingly every day, to now where you're sitting at this table as husband and wife. And it's been amazing. So please, everybody, join me in raising a glass and toasting to two people that are absolutely perfect for each other.
How about a nice hand for Jordan, everybody, as well as Melanie. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Sokolik. Come on, let's hear it for them. Let's go. David, we have been trying to get Steve to learn that song for so long, and since you requested it, he couldn't say no. So that was a first. So I'm telling you, how about a great big hand, Mr. Steve Spill up here? At this time, we'd like to bring Jenna's father to the dance floor and David's mom to the dance floor. How about a great big hand for Jeff Wolf and Ruth Sokolik, everybody? From the Drifters, this is a great song called Stand By Me. Here we go. You can go ahead and clap along if you'd like. Set this party on the right foot. Let's go.
No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Thank you. Thank you.
David and Jenna. Here we go. Let's do it.
Baby, shake it up, baby, now.
Shake it up, baby.
Come on, let's twist and shout.
Twist and shout.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby, now.
Come on, baby.
Come on, let's work it on out.
Work it on out.
Baby, twist it, girl.
Twist it, girl.
You know you're twisting so hard.
Twist so hard.
Come on, let's twist a little closer now.
Twist a little closer.
Just let me know that you are. Shake it, shake it, shake it, baby, now.
Shake it up, baby.
Don't worry, let's twist and shout.
Twist and shout.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby, now.
Come on, baby.
Come on, let's work it on out.
Work it on out.
I said let's work it on out now.
Work it on out.
You know you're looking so good.
Look so good.
Come on, let's twist a little closer now.
Twist a little closer.
Just like I knew that you would.
Like I knew you would. Come on now.
Features the one and only amazing Mark up here. How about a great big hand for Mark on the far right hand side?
All right, you can stop that right now.
Well, I've got to get it right out of the way. I have to acknowledge it.
I won't be able to get home, man.
Come on, fellas, bring the girls down to the dance floor. Here we go. See, now by right now, you should be headed to the dance floor with these young ladies. They're beautiful, always, but especially tonight. Bring them out here to the dance floor, fellas. Come on. You cannot lose with this one. It's a long weekend. Maybe start off on the right foot. Here we go. Come on.
For all of those who are not dancing right now, the cake is available in the back hallway.
Whoa. I need your love.
John.
Hello, Mark.
I found the grandmother of the groom. This is Esther. Everybody say hi to Esther.
Hi, Esther!
And guess what, dude? She let me sing to her and didn't even hit me.
She couldn't run fast enough. That was the only problem, brother. How about a great big hand for Esther? She's partying with us here tonight.
Got sunshine in my pocket that feels so lit.
Yes, everybody. Hey, put your hands together for Dan and Jenna. It's been a while. Oh. Can we take 3 minutes to sing a song to Jenna? I know you got photos and all that to do. Can you come on down to the dance floor, everybody? We're going to sing My Girl to Jenna right now. And we need everybody in the entire building to come down to the lower level and get in a great big oval all the way around and clap your hands to the beat. We're going to sing to this beautiful bride. Come on, people, get up. Let's go. We've got a great party here tonight. I need your help for 3 minutes. That's all it is. Come on, let's make the circle go all the way around. You guys in the center. There you go. Come on, clap your hands to the beat now. Let's go. We got more people coming. Make it all the way around. Let's go. We've got a lot of talent in the room tonight. I know that. And I know you can sing. Let me hear you say, are you ready to sing? Let me hear you say, yeah. Come on, one more time. Are you ready to sing tonight? Let me hear you sing, yeah. There you go. Come on, the beginning line now. You have to clap like that. All the way to the end. All the way to the end. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. And we're singing to Jenna, all right? Come on, let's do it. Everybody join me. Here we go. I'm going to count it off. One, two. Here we go. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside. Here we go. When it's cold.
Big head for David here tonight, everybody. Yeah. Oh, I got a
questions. First of all, are you marching tomorrow? You're not. Oh, wait a second.
He's a smart man.
Bob and I are going to be there. We're going to march 6 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, you got to
go. I think maybe you guys should come and march tomorrow. You don't think so?
You're not right.
All right, we'll excuse you one time. All right.
Oh, clap your hands.
Another question. Do you have any idea what you did today?
Yes.
How can he not?
Mary Jenna, that's awesome.
Oh, beautiful.
John, but tell him the real reality here.
David, you will never see the debit card again.
Oh.
It's gone, brother.
Oh. It's already gone, isn't it?
Come on, clap your hands.
Seriously, you know, back when Mom and Dad got married, you'll agree with this, I'm sure. Things were kind of, Dad was the ruler of the roost and Mom was just along for the ride. Is that how it was? You don't remember. That's a pretty good answer, actually. But anyways, coming back to today, things are more 50-50. You agree with that?
Sure.
Let me just show you. 90-10.
There you go.
So in that case, how many of you folks in this circle, I know we have all family and friends here, right?
Yep.
How many of you folks would love to hear this lovely bride sing to her husband?
Oh,
how many people want to hear Jenna tonight?
Set it up. Come on, Jenna's in the house. Here we go. And we are doing this to the Frank Sinatra song.
Good news, I don't need you to tell me. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. Please never want you. I long to stay. Thank you. the street to find I made number one, the top of the list. It's up to you, New
Let's do it.
Just the fire, the fire, the fire. Give a great big hand, everybody. Come on!
Sophia.
Bella.
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 Come on, put your hands together for me, everybody. Oh, we couldn't have done it without them. We're going to take another brief intermission. We'll be right back. Celebrating here with David and Jenna.
Thank you.
for a rehearsal.
Said it couldn't do it. Someone my hero.